Hello there, Matt with LINBIT here. I'm going to show you a demonstration today of LINBIT's new LINSTOR software. For those of you familiar with DRBD Manage, this will be a replacement technology for that piece of software in the sense that it will be managing your storage nodes in a storage cluster and deploying resources and managing configurations between those systems. What you see so far is just us starting up the LINSTOR control and satellite processes on our four nodes here. Brodo is going to be our controller node, so we've started both the controller and satellite. You see that there. The difference here is that the controller will manage the configurations for the cluster while the satellites will get their configurations from the controller node. So Frodo will be our controller here. And we're going to add him to the LINSTOR cluster as a combined type node. Again, just because of the controller and satellite services running on Frodo. And we'll go through and add the remaining three nodes as the default type, which would be a satellite node. Satellite nodes, again, are only providing storage to the storage cluster and not managing any configurations or anything like that. These steps should be somewhat familiar if you are familiar with DRBD Manage. We'll add Marion, and then we'll list out our cluster nodes to make sure that we all are participating. And there's all four nodes with Frodo standing out as the combined node type. Next, we'll go into defining our storage pool. DRBD Manage was really only for DRBD devices, and LINSTOR will be able to manage many more types of devices. So creating the storage definitions is a little more complicated, but it's for good reason. So we first define the storage pool definition, and then we will assign nodes to that storage pool. And we'll go through and declare this for all four nodes, but the things to note are we're using LVM as the backend, and we're naming it DRBD pool. So there is a volume group created called DRBD pool on all four nodes once these commands get pushed out. And we'll list out our storage pool. And we see that all four nodes are participating in the pool. So now we can go ahead and start creating our resources. We'll just use this for loop here to create 20 resources across all four nodes. For each resource, we have to create a resource definition, defining specifics to each of those resources, and just kind of roll with the defaults here, but then we'll create the volume definition. This specifies how many volumes, if more than one, would be participating in each of the resources. Finally, we create the resource inside of the DRBD pool that we previously created and assign it to a node. So we've already gone through 20 resources on all four nodes. We'll list them out. And, you know, obviously there's a lot of them, so this isn't a very efficient way to look at our resources. We'll open up DRBD Top. This will give us a perspective of all our resources from this node. We'll want to check each of the four nodes to make sure that our resources are all there. And since we sent all 20 to all nodes, we should see 20 of them there. Those red marks are just pointing out that the devices aren't in sync yet. We're still syncing everything up. So those are the quote unquote danger score, which helps us rank the order in which to display your resources. Different things go into that score, like the state of the DRBD device and how out of sync that device is. But we've already picked a block device just to wrap up this demonstration. We'll create a file system on it, put some test data on it, and just see that our data is being replicated. We don't have to wait for those full syncs to complete. That's been a feature of DRBD for as long as I can remember. All our replicated writes are taking precedence and, you know, happening side by side with that resync traffic. So we're just going to put a date and our name from this node onto our DRBD device, which we've mounted at MNT. That's what the data looks like. We'll flip back over to Legolas and see that it's there. And one of the things you should notice is we're not issuing any DRBD ADM ups or primaries or secondaries to move our DRBD device around. We're just relying on DRBD9's auto promote feature to manage that for us. That makes everything a lot smoother, makes it act like a normal old block device as opposed to some, you know, special block device. And we'll cat out our data, see that it's there, and that'll wrap up this demonstration. Thanks for watching.